Hello and welcome to another SolidWorks how-to video. In this video, I'm going to go through sort of an easy way to modify the parts in our assembly, or at least a quicker way to modify the parts. Sometimes, you know, especially when we're in the design phase, we'll go to put parts that we sort of design our parts separately. We bring them into assembly and then we decide that they actually don't work. Something was off, some measurement was off. How can we modify that in an easy way without having to go back through everything we've done up till now and create whole new parts, right? So I've got the sort of demo assembly open, our two plates with our four screws. And as I look at this assembly, I notice that the default SolidWorks countersink is not actually deep enough to recess the heads of my flathead screws. And that's something that I really want. I mean, typically, we use flathead screws for a number of reasons, but typically when we use flathead screws, we want them to sit below flush with the surface of the plate. So we really need to increase the size of that countersink. And to do that, we could open the part, right? Go to our Windows file manager, open the part in another window of SolidWorks. We could open the part in SolidWorks and edit it. But the quickest way to make a change similar to that is right here in the assembly view. If I click on this part and bring up the context tree, sort of the third, fourth icon here is edit part. And if I click that, okay, it wants the assembly to be saved. I haven't actually saved it, so let's do that. That's fine. Save all the documents. Everything that's saved, it wants saved. That's fine. Notice everything else besides this plate went transparent. The bottom plane is now transparent. The screws are transparent. It does that so that I can see this model of the top plate, the one with the clearance holes. And that's because I'm editing this. I need to be able to see all the features in order to edit them. And also, if we notice over here on our feature manager, right, the clearance plate is lit up blue because that is the part now that I'm editing. And I can now access directly any of the features in that part and change them. I could make it thicker if I wanted to. I don't really want to because honestly, my screws are already kind of, you know, bordering on too short for our little quick design here. But the countersink, if I click that, it brings up the context menu. And if I click the edit feature icon, I can change the whole wizard settings for those holes. So what I can do with a countersink, I could, you know, set custom dimensions and all kinds of cool things. But the best thing sort of to do is to click on head clearance, right? I want to add some depth to that hole to get the head set in further into the plate. That's really what head clearance is for. There are two options in head clearance. I can either increase the countersink or add a counterbore. A counterbore is just going to be like a straight walled inset, which is more complicated, frankly, from a machining standpoint, because that's probably a tool change. With an increased countersink, that's just saying I'm going to take the same countersink tool I'm already using and just drill deeper. We can go about it that way. And that's probably, with flatheads especially, the preferred method. And then I can define the depth. It's sort of a guess as to how deep you want to go. Let's start out and say 50 thousandths, 0.05 at first. We can see how that looks. Notice the yellow preview got significantly bigger, right? Because we're now drilling, we're countersinking 50 thousandths deeper. So the diameter got bigger. Our screws didn't move. Our screws didn't move because we're not editing the assembly right now. We are editing only this part. So I'm going to leave it at 50 thousandths for now. I'm going to accept, right? And now my preview, you know, the model reflects the preview, right? The diameters are bigger. I'm going to now accept the changes in the upper right here. I'm going to accept the changes to the part. Now the screws have set themselves in because they are mated to this countersunk surface. So I have to get out to the assembly level and accept all the way out to be able to sort of see the, you know, the result in the assembly. But that is a quick way that I can make a change to part of an assembly that just wasn't quite right. I can edit the part right here in this window without having opened it. Now, it's important to remember that I also, because I made a change to that part, I have not saved that file. And in my case, right here recording this video, that's not crucial. But for, you know, actual assemblies, things you're working on, you do want to control S and save all. That way, all changes that you may have made carry through and are now recorded. So that is the quick way to edit a part. We call it in context editing of a part in an assembly. So thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in another SolidWorks how-to video in the future.